First of all, you understand, we'll start with transfers. A lot of speculation of players Chelsea supposedly interested in. Is there a likelihood in seeing someone like Edin Dzeko? Is he a player you're interested in coming here? Perhaps with Batshuayi going the other way?
As you know very well, I think that it's not right to talk about the players of the other team, and I'm not interested in it. And, there is a transfer market in this period, and if happen something, I think that you are the first to know news.
There have been a lot of names linked, and one of them, I think, raised a few eyebrows was Peter Crouch. And I know you don't want to talk about individuals, but is Peter Crouch someone that you've identified, you've spoken to the board or whatever, and said that you're looking for someone of that nature, and Peter Crouch has come up?
But my answer is the same. And I'm not interested in. In this conversation, also because this disrespectful for my players, for the other players, for the players of the other club. As I said before, and this period there is a transfer market. If happens something, and for sure, you know, you are the first. You're the first media to know news.
I understand you don't want to talk about individual players, but the names of the players that have been linked, the likes of Crouch, of Dzeko, of Carroll, Llorente, they're all good in the air, they're all tall players. So even if you don't talk about individuals, is that something that you feel Chelsea needs? Would you appreciate having perhaps someone who's strong in the air, a big man up top, so to speak, to come into Chelsea? Is something you've identified that the team needs?
But in this moment, I can talk about my players, about Morata, about Batshuayi, about his characteristic. I think it's not right to talk about the characteristic of other players. And I always say that I'm happy to work with my players. I'm happy to try to improve my players. And every striker has the own characteristic. And in this case, Morata has a specific characteristic, Batshuayi has another characteristic. And I'm happy to work with my player, with my players, and for sure, I repeat, I don't want to talk about other players because it's not right.
You said throughout this transfer window that you can make suggestions to the board about players that you'd like to sign and so on. One thing hasn't been clear: you make your suggestions. Who has the final say on who you bid for and who you approach? Is it Mr. Abramovich? Is it a board? Is it a collective decision? But is there one person who has a final say on who you sign?
I think that I was very clear in the past to tell you that the club sometimes ask me my opinion about our transfer market, about our situation, the way that we can improve. But at the same time, I said in the past that the final decision is for the club, and this is our situation. This is the truth, and I think that. And the club has to spend money, and in this case, it's right to spend the money in the way that they prefer.
You say the club, though, so I mean, within the club, who are the people who are involved in that decision? Is it one specific or two people or a particular individual?
But I think that it's not right to speak about this about another person. I think it's right to talk about club, about the club generally. And to talk in general about the club.
Regarding the club and transfers, reports this morning of a FIFA investigation into signing young players from overseas and a potential two-transfer window ban if Chelsea found guilty. I mean, how damaging could that be for the club to miss out on two transfer windows?
I can answer that one for you, Roger. We're not commenting further than the statement we issued to media yesterday, which is that Chelsea FC complies with all FIFA statutes and regulations when recruiting players. That's the statement we put out there, and we're not commenting further on that situation or anything related to that situation, whether it be hypothetical or not.
Yeah, Antonio, if I could continue. Ross Barkley, you've had him for a couple of weeks now. Is he looking ready to play? How's he looked in training, and could he feature in the next match?
Yeah, I think Rose is in a good physical condition. Yeah, yesterday he played 70 minutes in a friendly game. Yeah, for tomorrow he's in the squad. He's coming with us for the game against Brighton. I don't know if during the game I decided to give him the chance to play a part of the game, or if I want to wait, if the game don't ask this type of situation. If the game doesn't ask this type of situation, but for sure now he's in the squad. He has to continue to improve, to work with us, with our idea. But now he's in the squad.
At the moment, Morata hasn't been getting the goals that he was getting earlier in the season. The team haven't been getting as many goals as perhaps you would like. Can you put your finger on exactly why that's been happening over the last few weeks?
Why? it's very difficult to find to have a good response this question. But I think that in every game we created many chances to score, and I think this is the most important things for us. At the same time, we must be honest and to tell that maybe our finishing could be better in our quality. Yeah, I think that our quality and the finishing could be better and to score more.
Just finally from me, just on VAR, which you felt should have been used in your game the other day. It's been used, trialled in these FA Cup matches as well. From what you've seen of it so far, What do you think of it, and would you like to see it being rolled out into the Premier League?
I like this new system, especially if this new system can help to reduce referee's mistake. In this case, and if you are able to use this new system in the right way. Can help you to have a game without a big mistake, big reference mistake. I think this is a good opportunity, but at the same time, I think that they have to improve a lot to use this new system, because in the way that now they are using is not correct.
In what way can they improve that then? How can they improve?
They have to see the other countries that are using this system for many times. For example, in Italy, they're using this system from the start of the season, and I think that the level to use this system is very good. And in Italy, our people are very happy to have this new system.
John.
Antonio, how concerned are you by your current form with two Premier League wins in five, and you haven't won this calendar year, you're drawing the last five? How concerning is it for you?
But for sure, we want to try to get 3 points in every game. And in the last period, I think that we drew many times. At the same time, there is a good aspect, because I think in official games we are unbeaten for many games, maybe 13, 14, and for sure we want to try to get 3 points in every game. But as you know very well, you have to score. You have to score to win the game. And in the last couple of the weeks, I think we were also a bit unlucky. But at the same time, I think that we were not so accurate in our finishing.
I know you don't want to talk about players you're trying to sign, but are you confident that you're going to get the players that you want in the transfer window?
I'm confident. Confident is a big word, and we have to wait. We have to wait. I repeat. I give my opinion to my club. But as I said before, the final decision is for the club, and I have to wait and to see what happens during this transfer market. But I repeat, I'm very calm under this aspect, also because I'm working with my players in the right way, and I'm very happy for the commitment of my players. I'm very happy to work with these players. And then if the club wants to help us, we are happy. Otherwise, we continue in this way, and we continue to put all ourselves every day to try to improve the team, to try to give satisfaction for our fans.
Have you had a word with your players, particularly Pedro and Morata, and the squad really about diving?
I must be honest. I think I watched the three situations during Norwich, and I think William's situation was very clear. No, it was a big mistake. Then Morata, I think that there is a foul. Then you can decide to concede or not a penalty, but there is a contact, and there is not a diving. For Pedro, we must be honest and to accept that Pedro is diving. Yeah, and I think the player. No, but I think in this situation the player is clever, is intelligent to understand when you make a mistake. And I think in this case Pedro understood his mistake.
Okay, Matt, please.
Antonio, some of the names Chelsea have been linked with, does that suggest the short-termism of transfer policy at the moment?
Another transfer window question. With the names that have been mentioned in the media, Does that suggest that Chelsea only have a short-term vision, not a long-term vision? Because of the names that are being mentioned in the media.
Yeah. I don't know. I think that during the transfer market, especially in January, and if you go into the transfer market, it means that you need to improve your squad, and you have to see in short period, and you have to see in long period. Yeah.
In terms of team news, how are Cahill and Fabregas?
Yeah, they are out. And I have to check a couple of situations for tomorrow's game. Yeah, but Cahill and Fabregas are out.
Can you tell us who else you need to check on the bounce?
No, I prefer to keep secret.
Okay. And you've always often talked about you prefer to say a bad truth than a good lie. When we ask you about transfers in particular, do you ever tell a good lie?
No. As you know very well, I like to tell, always to tell the truth. And the truth is always the same. And
Izzo.
Antonio, Morata's got 8 yellow cards this season and he's suspended for this next game. Does he have a discipline problem and is it coming from frustration on the pitch?
Yeah, for sure, for Norwich game, I think the player knows very well his mistake. There was frustration for the first yellow card because the player I didn't deserve this yellow card. If the referee doesn't want to concede the penalty, I think that in this situation and it's not right to book him. But at the same time, you must learn to control himself. Because the second yellow card was for dissent, and I agree with the player for the first yellow card, but I'm not agree with the player for the second yellow card, and for sure you have to check better himself in the future.
Is there a psychological issue with him because he's not scoring but he's picking up cards and maybe he was a bit unlucky but he's got 8 overall this season, which is quite a lot. Is there a psychological issue around him?
Yeah, but for the striker, the situation can happen. For sure, for Alvaro, this is the first season that he's playing, he's having a full season. And maybe for him, this is the first time to face this type of problems. But he has to overcome this problem because it is a stupid problem. And you can score. The most important thing to work for the team and don't lose the confidence. Also because the coach trusts him. The teammates trust him, the clubs trust him, the fans trust him. I don't see any problem, but this is the first time for Morata and to face this type of situation because this is the first time that he's playing the full season. Before, if you stay on the bench, you don't have this type of pressure. But he has to learn to face this situation and to go forward, to move on, and also because everyone in Chelsea trust him.
Sorry. Antonio, it's only a few weeks since you beat Brighton. What did you learn from them in that match?
I guess Brighton. I learned that we have to pay great attention tomorrow. Brighton played a really good game against us, and especially in the first half. They were very compact, very solid defensively. And this is a good team with a really good coach. I had the opportunity to know this coach. I think he's a really good coach. We must pay great attention tomorrow. Also because we are playing a game in only 2 days at 12:30, and many players played at 120 minutes, and also the penalty. Yeah, you have to pay great attention. We must be focused, and tomorrow the game won't be easy for us, and we must be ready.
That in mind, how much will Morata and Pedro be missed?
Yeah, for sure, this is another problem, and this problem, in this part of the season, in this moment, this is a big problem. Also, because Morata. Didn't play against Norwich, or he played only 20 minutes, and he was resting for the game against Brighton. And for this reason, I have to change the plane. Sometimes, when you ask you have a plan to face this busy period, you can have a plan, but then there is the game, anything can happen, a red card, an injury, and you have to change your plane. For sure, I have to change my plane for Brighton's game.
Just finally, how hard is it to motivate your players when Manchester City are so far ahead?
I think that we have a great motivation, a fantastic motivation, no? And this motivation is to try to finish the league in the Final Four. And it won't be easy. I want to be very clear, we are in January, and to reach this result, it will be very difficult for not only for us, but also for the other teams, because it will be a big fight, a bit war, with five teams for only four places.